The featherweight Muay Thai world champ Petmorakhet Pityindi duked it out for 5 close rounds against Jimmy Vanneau at 1-157, and it took a split decision to beat him. For the first 2 rounds, the Frenchman, who has won world titles with multiple promotions and sanctioning bodies, gave Petmorakhet a real run for his money. JV was catching and countering to land as often as the champ, and even began bullying him up against the cage. In the championship rounds, though, the challenger missed with a right high kick and his jaw was met by a stiff right hook in reply. Petmorakhet's punch dropped Vanneau for an 8 count that undoubtedly earned the champ some crucial points and ultimately the victory. With the win, the Thai Dynamo pushed his incredible record out to 165, 35, and 2, and sealed his 3rd consecutive world title defense. On top of that, the 28-year-old earned a handy 50K performance bonus. In the co-main, Joseph Lasiri's fairy tale career comeback continued when he forced the strawweight Muay Thai world champ Prajin Chai PK Senchai to throw in the towel, especially after Lasiri started his one tenure with 4 straight losses. After a close first round where neither man could find their target, the Hurricane cracked the champ with a hard right hand, then an uppercut to knee combo that busted Prajin Chai wide open. The champ was bleeding and in trouble from then on. With his confidence at an all-time high, Lasiri spent the 3rd round pumping heavy hands into the champ's face. When it came time to come out for the 4th round, Prajin Chai shocked everyone by not getting up from his stool and telling his corner and the referee that he could no longer continue, much to the excitement of the new champ and his team. Lasiri was awarded the TKO victory, improved his career record to 43-12, and became the 3rd one strawweight Muay Thai world champ. To add to the celebration, he was also awarded a 50K performance bonus. Also on the card was the entire quarterfinal round of the flyweight Muay Thai GP, and Rod Tang Jitwangnam looked phenomenal against Jacob Smith. The reigning champ spent 3 rounds blasting the Englishman with a barrage of the Iron Man's usual blows, and it looked painful. Walter Gonzalez took just 35 seconds to win his quarterfinal after 24 hours of absolute uncertainty. The Brazilian was scheduled to face the former champ Jonathan Haggerty, who withdrew after not being medically cleared. Josue Cruz stepped up that day and then sat down not long after, thanks to a shellacking by Gonzalez. Superlek Kapmukau overwhelmed Taiki Naito en route to a convincing unanimous decision in their quarterfinal bout. The kicking machine put on a brutal performance, throwing everything he had with bad intentions. If it wasn't leg kicks from the outside, it was nasty elbows from the pocket, and Naito didn't have any answers. And in the 4th quarterfinal, Savas Michael outworked Amir Nasseri for a clear-cut unanimous decision. While his opponent attempted to bring the pressure, the WBC and WMC Muay Thai world champ's composure, fight IQ, and precision proved too much for the one debutante. The card also featured the victorious debut of the 19-year-old Ruotolo brothers in a pair of submission grappling bouts. Thai quickly submitted BJJ superstar Gary Tonin with a darce choke in just 1 minute and 37 seconds, the quickest finish in one submission grappling history. And while his brother Cade couldn't submit Shinya Aoki, he did dominate him for the decision. Ruotolo relentlessly pushed the action with innovative attacks all throughout the 10-minute encounter, and the former lightweight MMA champ was forced to constantly defend a whirlwind of varied offense, including this modified buggy choke. Aoki survived until the final bell, but the win was clear-cut for the Brazilian. And in the opening bounce of the night, Elise Anderson survived an early scare to submit Ashoroka in the 1st round. The American was dropped early, but then defended from her back with an armbar. Lil Savage then switched to a deep triangle choke that forced the tap 2 minutes and 4 seconds into the opening frame. And Wonder Girl made her mixed martial arts debut against the now formerly unbeaten Zebabano. The Muay Thai sensation needed just over a minute to submit Bana with an armbar that pleased no one more than Wonder Girl herself. Thanks for watching, and remember, if you want more fight sports in your life, just hit the subscribe button.